Congratulations to NAIOP New Jersey, 50 years of service to the Garden State.
Happy birthday, NAIOP. Congratulations on 50 years.
50 very successful years, and here's to 50 more.
50 years and getting stronger.
Thanks for all the wonderful things you do in the community and for us every day. Look forward to working with you.
Well, I haven't been a member for all 50 years. I've really enjoyed my time with the organization.
I've been a member since I first got into the business about 20 years ago. I really value that relationship and what it's done for me.
Much more success to NAIOP in the future.
Here's to the next 50 years.
Congratulations, NAIOP New Jersey, on 50 years of representing our great industry.
In 1970, David Steiner and Frank Vashelia Sr. met for lunch to discuss ways to counter an overly burdensome regulatory environment. This was the genesis of the New Jersey chapter of NAIOP, uniting all facets of the non-residential development sector to advocate for pro-growth public policy. The group then began hosting breakfast meetings on legislative and regulatory topics, attracting more and more developers. In 1974, the chapter was officially incorporated and formed a legislative committee. The 1980s brought the cubicle farm to the office environment and the rise of the industrial warehouse complex known as 8A. NAIOP's membership continued to grow steadily, and the first gala was held in 1988. The 1990s were challenging for New Jersey cities, but by the end of the decade, a booming national economy helped most urban areas rebound. Impact fees, ECRA reform, and the state plan topped NAIOP's legislative agenda, and the New Jersey chapter received the NAIOP National Award for Best Public Affairs Program. The new century brought the tragedy of September 11th, and NAIOP members responded immediately with space for emergency operations and financial support. New Jersey's Ann Evans Estabrook became the first woman to chair NAIOP National in 2001. New Jersey's strategic location, transportation network, and increased port activity propelled the growth of industrial real estate. By 2008, Northern New Jersey was the ninth largest market for co-location and data center services in the U.S., and demand grew for flexible workspaces. The LSRP program was created to deal with a backlog of 20,000 contaminated sites. Superstorm Sandy in 2012 fueled demand for resilience, the security of duplicated systems, backup generators, and even redundant utility feeds. The Economic Opportunity Act of 2013 gave New Jersey powerful incentives to attract new jobs and investments as the state's economy continued to struggle in the wake of the Great Recession. As we moved further into the century, e-commerce drove a red-hot industrial market and ever-expanding warehouse distribution facilities. Demographic shifts, globalization, the mobile economy, the imperative to capture and retain young talent, aging infrastructure, and sustainable energy influenced public policy and investment decisions. And although the term telecommute was coined back in 1972, only a fraction of the workforce worked remotely until the COVID-19 pandemic changed everything. 50 years after that historic lunch, NAIOP has grown from the founding four to over 800 members today. NAIOP's core mission remains advocacy, and many of the issues that moved our founders to action in 1970 are the same we face today. Whether the challenges and obstacles emanate from Trenton, Washington, or Mother Nature, NAIOP always has your back. Here's to the next 50 years of NAIOP New Jersey.